I'm in the mood for singing, singing along with you. I'm in the mood for singing, singing along with you. I'm in the mood for singing, singing along with you. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that today. Hey, hey, what do you say? I'm in the mood for that.
Welcome to the School of Home, Circle Time with the Mirabellis. Brought to you by Maple Syrup. Day three.
As with any school day, we start with a prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God, we thank you for this day, for home and school, and work and play. For wind and rain and sun above, most of all for those we love. Today we'd like to especially pray for all those who are at home and are feeling sad, lonely, scared, or nervous. We pray that everyone has enough food and money to pay for the things that they need. We thank you, God, for the healthcare workers and other people who support taking care of us during this trying time. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This morning, Tommy, would you like to introduce our book for today?
Yes. Drum roll, please. The book is today, A Day at the Sugar Bush.
So, this time of year is an excellent time to visit the sugar bush. Unfortunately, all our sugar bushes in the area are closed down, but we can visit the sugar bush in a book. And so our book is called A Day at the Sugar Bush. This is a non-fiction book, which means it's real.
A Day at the Sugar Bush. It's the first week of spring, the days are warm and the nights are cold. It's time to visit the sugar bush. We'll find out how tree sap is made into maple syrup and maple sugar. There are many kinds of maple trees. In the sugar bush, the most common kind is the sugar maple because it has the sweetest sap. Sap is the liquid that flows inside the tree. It carries nutrients to the leaves, branches, trunks, and roots. During the sugaring off season, when a hole is drilled into the trunk of a maple tree, the clear, watery sap begins to flow out. A spout, called a spile, is hammered into the hole. The sap drips into a pail that hangs from the spile. We taste the fresh sap from the maple tree. It is slightly sweet. Then we taste some sap that has been boiled into maple syrup. It is very sweet. We see how pioneers emptied the sap buckets into bigger pails and carried them with a yoke to the sugar kettles. We try it too. An easier way to collect the sap was to pour it into a gathering tank that horses could pull. Once the sap is collected, it must be boiled for a long time. The water in the sap turns into steam. This is called evaporation. Nowadays, many maple syrup producers use plastic tubes to carry the sap from the trees to a stainless steel holding tank. Sometimes a vacuum pump sucks the sap through the tubes. We watch the sap boil in the compartments of a large flat-bottom pan called an evaporator. We add more wood to the fire to keep the sap boiling. It gets thicker and thicker. Finally, the sap moves to the last compartment called the finishing pan. The last traces of excess water evaporate, leaving behind sweet golden brown maple syrup. A tap is opened to drain the finished syrup. In this picture, you can see 40 pails of sap make this much syrup. One pail or all of these together. It is filtered twice to remove any dirt. To do this, the pioneers strained it through cheesecloth. The hot syrup is poured into bottles and sealed. Now it is ready to enjoy. To make maple candy, the syrup is boiled longer. We watch it become very thick. Then it is poured into molds where it hardens. If the syrup is boiled until all the moisture is gone, it becomes maple sugar. Early Canadian cooks depended on maple sugar to add a sweet flavor to their cooking and baking. Before we leave the sugar bush, there's a special treat for us. Pancakes with maple syrup, of course. Delicious. Long ago, the first taste of maple syrup. Long ago, before Europeans arrived in Canada, native peoples in the eastern woodlands were tapping maple trees and using the sap to make maple syrup and sugar. How was the sweet sap discovered? An Iroquois legend tells that a boy noticed a squirrel bite off a sugar maple twig and lick the sap that oozed out. When he tasted the sap himself, he found that it was sweet. Native maple syrup makers were quick to discover the delicious combination of hot maple syrup and fresh cold snow. Tire sur la neige. Syrup on snow sundae. You can make your own version of tire sur la neige at home. Simply pour pure maple syrup over a scoop or two of snowy white vanilla ice cream. Top with maple candy, whole or crumbled. Cold and sweet.
I hope that you enjoyed our maple sugar book. We're now going to sing a song. And you might be wondering why I have spoons. Well, my dad's favorite dessert, one of his favorite desserts, was having ice cream with maple syrup. And so, of course, you would eat ice cream with a spoon. I'd like you to pause your video, and you're going to need two spoons for this next song.
Thank you.
All right, are we ready? You have your spoons ready? So usually in the classroom, we have tapping sticks that we use to create some drumming. I had a request from a little friend named Logan yesterday, and he wanted to do the drumming song. I think this is the one that he wanted. So, Logan, this is for you and for all our friends to enjoy. I'm tapping on my spoon, tapping on my spoon, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my spoon. I'm tapping very quickly, tapping very quickly, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping very quickly. I'm tapping very quietly, tapping very quietly, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping very quietly. I'm tapping very loudly, tapping very loudly, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping very loudly. I'm tapping on my head, tapping on my head, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my head. I'm tapping on my shoulders, tapping on my shoulders, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my shoulders. Do you have an idea? I'm tapping on my knees, tapping on my knees, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my knees. I'm tapping on my toes, tapping on my toes, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my toes. I'm tapping on my
legs.
I'm tapping on my legs. Tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my legs. I'm rolling, 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 rolling. I'm tapping on my tummy. I'm tapping on my tummy. Tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my tummy. I'm tapping on my elbows, tapping on my elbows, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my elbows. I'm tapping on my knees, switch, tapping on my knees, switch, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my knees, switch. I'm tapping on my collarbone, tapping on my collarbone, tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my collarbone. I'm tapping on my
nose.
Nose. I'm tapping on my nose. Tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my nose. I'm tapping on my chin. Tapping on my chin. Tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my chin. I'm tapping on my
fingers.
I'm tapping on my fingers. Tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my fingers. I'm tapping
on my hair.
I'm tapping on my hair. Tapping, tapping, never stopping, tapping on my hair. Another drumming song that we like to sing during Christmas time is The Little Drummer Boy. So, tap along with me. Come, they told me, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. A newborn king to see, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. Our finest gifts we bring, ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. So to honor him, pa-ra-ba-bum. with us today, if you would like to request a song or a story, and if I have it at home, I would be glad to do that. You can contact me through email, contact us through email, and we would like to say thank you very much for watching our videos and singing along with us. We've had some requests for eat the banana microphone.
Oh yeah.
And we'll leave you with our closing song.
Go
now in peace.